सदाशिव समारंभाम शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंताम वंदे गुरु परंपराम श्रुति श्रुति पुराणानाम आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योममद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माणं विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तदुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्घनगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं स्वप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्य बुद्धिर्यत्न निर्मलम् अपारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम महः तदेव अहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। सो द कंपैरिजन बिटवीन द घटाकाश एंड घटाकाश एंड या घटाकाश एंड जीव जलाकाश एंड ईश्वर सॉरी जलाका घटाकाश एंड कूटस्थ जलाकाश एंड जीव मेघाकाश एंड ईश्वर एंड महाकाश एंड ब्रह्म। दिस इज द मेथडोलॉजी वेयर बाय द तत्वदृष्टिस क्वेश्चन इज बीइंग आंसर्ड। And it is said that if you inquire into this example, that is sufficient. You yourself will land on the conclusion. All the doubts will go away. There, Ghatakasha was explained as the space taken by a Jalapurita Ghata to place a pot full of water. And Jalakasha is the Akasha reflected in the water as well as the Akasha in the Ghata, taken by the Ghata. Both put together are Jalakasha. This comparable to Jiva. Then what is Meghakasha? We saw till Jalakasha yesterday. Meghakasha. Meghasthitaye yavana akasho avakasham dadati tavana akashaha. Meghajale prativimbita akashascha iti ubhayam militva Meghakasha ityabhidiyate. So what is Meghakasha? The space taken by the cloud and the... I think we didn't do this. And it's the space taken by the cloud as well as the reflected space in the water inside the cloud, the rain water inside the cloud, pre-rain of course. So megha jale prativimbita akasha also. Militva megha akasha iti abhidiyate. Now here there is a question. Nanu akashe asti megha tatra meghe jalam आकाश प्रतिबिंबश्च अस्ति इत्यत्र किं मानम् इति चेत् न। सो सिद्धांति टेल्स दी पूर्व पक्षी दैट यू शुड नॉट डाउट। सो व्हाट इज द डाउट? द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज द प्रमाण देयर? प्रमाण टू से देयर इज जला इन मेघा, इन द क्लाउड देयर इज जला एंड देयर इज प्रतिबिंब आल्सो। यू आर मेकिंग टू जंप्स। यू आर एज्यूमिंग देयर इज वॉटर एंड यू आर एज्यूमिंग दैट द वॉटर रिफ्लेक्ट्स in the cloud. So answer is yadyapi meghe jalasya akashat pratibimbasya cha na pratyakshatah grahanam, meaning pratyaksha pramana isn't there. I don't see water in the cloud and I do not see the reflection in the cloud. Still anumanena grahanam athapi anumanena grahanam sambhavatyeva. There is an anumana because you see rain falling outside out from the clouds, therefore there has to be water inside the cloud for the rainwater to be there. And then wherever there is water, you see reflection is there, clear water is there especially, and the rainwater is clear. So there has to be reflection even within the cloud. And the akasha being reflected has already been established. Anyway, that reminds me, there is another point to be covered. एनीवे आई विल फिनिश दिस एंड देन द टिप्पणा पॉइंट इज रिमेनिंग तथा ही मेघात जलवृष्टे हे दर्शनात दैट इज द हेतु फॉर अनुमान देर इज जलवृष्टि द रेन फॉल्स फ्रॉम द मेघा मेघात जलवृष्टे हे दर्शनात तत्र जलमस्ति इति अनुमीयते देन यदि मेघे जलम न स्यात् तर्हि ततो जलवृष्टिर्न स्यात् सो व्याप्ति इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड एंड यू सी दैट अनुमान इज वर्किंग देयर बाय देयर हैज टू बी वाटर रेन वाटर इन द क्लाउड किंच मेघस्थम जलम आकाश प्रतिबिंब विशिष्टम स्वच्छ द्रव्यत्वात् स्वच्छ द्रव्य इज हेतु एनी स्वच्छ द्रव्य रिफ्लेक्ट्स देयरफॉर दर्पणादिवत दर्पणादिवत स्वच्छ द्रव्यत्वात् मेघस्थम जलम आकाश प्रतिबिंब विशिष्टम दी जला इन दी क्लाउड द वॉटर इन दी क्लाउड्स शुड बी रिफ्लेक्टिंग शुड हैव अ रिफ्लेक्टिंग सर्फेस इफ देर इज अ सर्फेस यू कंसिडर सर्फेस वाई बिकॉज स्वच्छ द्रव्य जस्ट लाइक अ मिरर इत्यनुमानेन मेघस्थ जले आकाश प्रतिबिंबानुमानं च सिद्ध्यति Thereby, there is water in the clouds and the water in the cloud reflects as well. This has been established through inference. Yadyasti jalam tarhi tajjalam akasha pratibimbena vinana syad itihi niyamaha. If there is water, it cannot be without reflecting. It has to reflect. This is a niyama. It is a rule. Wherever you see water, you cannot have clear water especially. You cannot have water without reflection the water will reflect evam meghe jalam tatra akasha pratibimbascha anumanena prasidhyati so the cloud space has been established as the space which is taken by the cloud as well as the reflected space in the cloud the space reflected by the water in the cloud so both put together that is called as megha akasha We left one point in the here. So this is the second point in the Tippana, which was raised. I can't see the point there where it was. Anyway, the question is one part we saw as. The ghatantarvarti akasha it even if so akasha pratibimba nakshatradisahita yesterday we saw that nakshatradisahita akasha pratibimba is there in ghata jala reflects the akasha also along with nakshatradi the objection was nakshatra etc They can be reflected. The moon can be reflected. But why do you say that the Akasha is reflected? There we saw the Goshpada. In that example, we saw. Anyway, an interesting point. I find it interesting for those who are interested in Vyakarana. How do you get the Goshpada? Goshpada word itself has a. Generally, you should have a Gopada Shabda. It is not Gopada. It is Goshpada. Gopada is also a valid word, but not in this context. When the Gopada is the footprint of the cow in on land, wherever, the footprint. But Goshpada, there is a Sudagama and then there is Shatvam, Murdhanya. When there is, the Goshpada is a measure. That's why Parimana. When it is the footprint of the cow is not intended, but what is intended is the measure of the size of the foot of the cow. When that is the intention to be conveyed, then that time you get the Shabda Goshpada. It is only for measure. There is another meaning also, but this is the meaning that we are looking at here. There is one specific Vyakarana Sutra, Panini Sutra, Ashtadhyayi Sutra, only for this word, Vyutpatti of Goshpada. So it can be considered a Nipata also. Okay, so... There, the example was given that a huge reflection in small body of water, that's all it is. Huge reflection in the small body of water is possible only when the space that holds this huge body is also reflected. Otherwise, you won't have space for the huge body to be there itself, let alone the reflection. So, avakasha pradatru akasham or avakasha pradata akashaha has to be there to give avakasha to the huge body. Unless that is there, you cannot have that kind of an akasha is reflected. You cannot have a reflected body of that size. Now, the question is, there is no guna. So, earlier the objection was, there is no rupa. If there is no rupa, how can you have reflection? Akasha has no rupa. Rupa raita akashasya pratibimbo katham bhavet. So there, the example was given, shabda. You have shabda pratidhvani. And pratidhvani, the echo is similar to reflection. Shabda is rupa raita. Still you have it. But then the question can be, shabda has guna. I mean, shabda itself is guna really. So, not shabda has guna, but he's there also there can be an argument. This is an answer given to the objection that rupa rahitasya katham pratibimbo bhavet. And it is also a refutation of objection for chaitanya not being reflected. So, what is the argument there? That is discussed here. Gunaha gunam ashrityena tishtati. Now, this is technical as per Nayayikas. We argue with Nayayikas. If Nayayikas say that guna has to be there for it to be reflected, Chaitanya does not have any guna. Akasha is reflecting because Akasha is Shabda Gunavan. Akasha has Shabda Guna. Akashasya Shabdaha. That being the case, it can, let's say, Akasha is reflecting. What about Chaitanya? How can Chaitanya reflect? Chaitanya is nirguna. So there the question is, now your guna. Does guna have guna? Dravya has guna. Those who have studied Tarka Shastra, it will be easier. Otherwise, I'll just explain for completion. Guna does not have, guna cannot have guna. Dravya can have guna. If guna has guna, then guna will become dravya. It will not remain guna. So, shabda itself does not have shabda. But shabda is reflected through pratidhvani. So, guna ha gunam ashritya na tishtati. Guna cannot have guna. Kintu dravyam evaiti niyamaha. This is your niyama. We tell the nayayika, this is your niyama. Guna can be there in the dravya, it cannot be there in the guna itself. So, dravya is guni. Between guna and guni, there is nitya sambandha. Dravya, which is a guni, has guna. Guna itself cannot have guna. Shabda is a guna. So we'll just give some example. But there is a reflection. Atascha gunatvena abhimatani neelapitadi varnani neerupani eva. But let's stick to the rupa example itself. Does the rupa reflect? Rupa, primary meaning is color, we saw yesterday. Form is another meaning. But primary meaning as per Nayayikas, rupa means a color. Now, whether it is dark brown or, you know, red or whatever, you know, neela, peeta, blue, yellow, whatever color, do the colors reflect? Wherever it is, we don't care where it is reflecting. Do the color reflects in the mirror, water, wherever? Obviously, they do reflect. Now, how do they reflect? How can guna reflect? Guna is, this rupa is a guna. Shabda sparsha, rupa rasa gandha, these are all gunas. Now, rupa as an example, shabda we have seen in pratidhvani, but we are saying rupa itself reflects. Now, this rupa reflecting, color reflecting, does the color have guna? No, it does not have guna. Color cannot have guna. Color itself is a guna. Thereby, neelapitadini varnani neerupani eva. They themselves do not have rupa. They are guna rahita. They don't have rupa. So, rupa rahitasya neerupasya. Rupa rahitasya is neerupasya. Neerupa is same as rupa rahita. How can there be reflection? Just as color reflects, color itself is a rupa. It cannot have rupa. हाउ डज दैट रिफ्लेक्ट तथापि तेषां स्वच्छ दर्पणादो प्रतिबिंबो दृष्टः यू सी द कलर रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन द मिरर एवमेव सो दैट्स ऑल वी वांट टू आर्ग्यू एवमेव रूपरहितयोः आकाश चैतन्ययोश्च प्रतिबिंबः संभवेदेव सिमिलरली आकाश एंड चैतन्य ऑल्दो दे डू नॉट हैव रूप एंड फर्दर बाय एक्सटेंशन दे डोंट हैव एनी गुण आल्सो आकाश हैज शब्द गुण बट चैतन्य हैज नो गुण इवन देन देयर कैन बी रिफ्लेक्शन दिस इज एन ऑब्जेक्शन इवन टू रिफ्यूटेशन ऑफ ऑब्जेक्शन इवन ऑफ भामतिकारा Bhamatikara says this Pratibimba Vada won't work because Chaitanya is Nirguna, it cannot reflect. But a similar objection can be raised. How can you segment this Akasha? You cannot have Avachheda Vada also. No Vada is going to be complete. In case of Maya and in case of Chaitanya, no examples will work perfectly. All these are to take away some doubts which are lingering on. To take away the impossibility. Once you come to possibility, you hold on to that. Then once you land on the tattva, then all methodologies are okay. It will seem that when you give space for a possibility, impossibilities are removed. Then once you get the tattva, you will see otherwise it is not possible. Tattva has to be understood in such a manner that there is no other possibility other than aikya. So whether Pratibimba, Abhasa, Avachheda, all these are irrelevant at that stage. Anyway, so that was one part remaining. Now what is Mahakashaha? Brahmandasya Antarvahischa. This entire universe, Brahmanda is the entire universe. Antarvahihi. Whichever Padartha you take, there is space within and without, outside. Brahmandasya Antarvahischa, this is manifested universe which is ever expanding. Now for it to expand also there has to be space outside. So brahmandasya antarvaischa vyapya ekarupena vartamanah akasha mahakasha iti uchyate vidvadbhi. So all pervasive space which is inside and outside everything, the entire universe, that space is mahakasha or total space. Now this is the example. All the four things of the example are, four units are explained. Chaitanyasya Chaturvidhya Varnanam. In the exemplified Chaitanya, how are there four namings done? Divisions, so to say. Upodghata, introduction here. He Somya, Chaturvidha Akasha Lakshanam Uktam. We have seen in the example the four types of Akasha. चतुर्विध चैतन्य लक्षणम अपि उच्यमानम श्रुणु. नाउ प्लीज लिसन टू व्हाट इज बीइंग टॉट अबाउट द चैतन्य भेद भेद एव भेद फोर टाइप्स ऑफ डिविजन्स ऑफ चैतन्य. देयर इज अ टिप्पणा टू दैट, वी विल जस्ट गो टू दैट. दिस इज नॉट सो लेजिबल बट आई विल सी व्हाट कैन बी डन. केषुचित् अद्वैत ग्रंथेषु जीव ईश ब्रह्मेति चित् त्रैचित्रैविध्यम् चित्रैविध्य प्रक्रिया आश्रिता केषुचित् अद्वैत ग्रंथेषु. सो इन अद्वैत ग्रंथा इटसेल्फ देयर आर जीव ईश एंड ब्रह्म. जीव ईश एंड ब्रह्म देयर आर थ्री डिविजन्स मेड. चित्रैविध्य प्रक्रिया आश्रिता. So jiva is chetana, chaitanya vastu, isha is chaitanya and brahma is chaitanya. So jiva chaitanya, ishara chaitanya or isha chaitanya and brahma chaitanya, these are the three types of chit. Anadi padartha shatka nirupane chaitanya traividhyam eva uktam. And when we saw the six anadis, in the six anadis there is only चैतन्य त्रैविध्य मीनिंग जीव ईश ब्रह्म देन अविद्या देयर संबंध ऑल दिस हैज बीन मेंशन. ऑल दीज आर सिक्स अनादिज, दे हैव नो बिगिनिंग. तत्र कूटस्थ परित्यागात कूटस्थ इज एंड देयर. नाउ दिस पॉइंट इज मेंशनड हियर. चतुर्विध एंड कूटस्थ हैज बीन मेंशनड. कूटस्थ जीव ईश्वर एंड ब्रह्म. So Jiva Ishvara Brahma is covered in other Advaita Granthas. Kutastha is not covered. However, in here he is mentioning four Vedas where Kutastha is mentioned. This Kutastha is not mentioned in some Advaita Granthas. Only Chaitanya Traividya has been mentioned where Kutastha isn't there. And in the Anadi Padartha Shatka Nirupan, in the description given in the Shloka also, Siddhikara, Bhagavan Siddhikara gives this. Bhagavan Madhusana Saraswati. Siddhikara is Advaita Siddhikara. Anadi Padartha Shatka Nirupane. He has quoted this. There are six Anadis. Kutastha isn't there. So where do you get this Kutastha from? This is the question. Purva Paksha. Tatra Kutastha Parityaga Na Kopi Dosha Syat. Kutastha may not have been mentioned in that, but it is still covered. How so? Kutastha Brahmanor na nama matra bheda dhruti anya kashchana bhedosti. Nama matra bheda dhruti anya kashchana bhedaha nasti. This na will go here with the verb. So between Kutastha and Brahma, there is only nama matra bheda. Other than nama matra bheda, no other bheda is there. Kashchana bhedaha nasti. Nama matra bheda dhrute. Rute will govern panchami. So nama matra bheda dhrute anya kashchana bhedaha kutastha brahmanor nasti. Isn't there? Meaning Brahma has been mentioned. Jiva isha Brahma. Nama matra bheda is there. Kutastha as kutastha. So when you said Brahma, then Kutastha is as well covered. Kincha, further he gives another pramana because Panchadashikara mentions this. Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya says, Kincha Vidyaranya Munikruta Drigdrishya Vivekakhya Granthe. So Panchadashikara says in his own work Drigdrishya Viveka, which is a combined work, it is said. It is by Bhagavan Bharati Tirtha also, who was his guru. So Vidyaranya Munikruta Drigdrishya Vivekakhya Granthe, in that Drigdrishya Viveka, Kutastha Paramarthika Jivaha Jagratkalika Antakkarana Pratibimbaha Vyavaharika Jivaha Swapnadruk Pratibhasika Jiva iti cha Nirupitam. So Drigdrishya Viveka has three descriptions of Jiva. So one explanation is that Brahma includes the word Kutastha because Brahma and Kutastha have only nama matra bheda. Another way to see it as what the way Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya says. He says in Drigdrishya Viveka, there are three ways to understand Jiva. There are three parts to Jiva rather, perspectives, three realities. What are these? Paramarthika, then Vyavaharika, and Pratibhasika. We know these three sattas. So Jiva also has the three sattas. The real Jiva is Kutastha Brahma. Kutastha Chaitanya is non-different from Brahma. There is no difference at all. That is the Paramarthika Jiva. That is the real Jiva. Jiva Brahma even aparaha elsewhere. Jagrat Kalika and Swapnadruk. There is Jagrat Avastha Abhimani and Swapna Abhimani. Swapnavastha Abhimani. Jagratavastha Abhimani, who is called as Vishwa, he is the Antakkarana Pratibimbaha. Antakkarana is active. That time, Vyavaharika Jivaha. He is Vyavaharika Jiva. The Pratibimba of Chaitanya, Kutastha really, Kutastha Chaitanya or Brahma Chaitanya Pratibimba in the Antakkarana during Jagratavastha, clearly known, it is always there, but in Jagrat Avastha it is known, that is Vyavaharika Jivaha. During the Swapna, Pratibhasika Jivaha iti cha Nirupitam. So same Brahma is called as Kutastha in the Paramartha Satta. In Vyavahara, he is the Antakkarana Pratibimba, and Pratibhasika Jiva is during the Swapna. Anena Kutastha Jiva Kotau Antarbhavitaha. therefore another way to say it is kutastha is within the jiva triad. Either you have brahma nama matra bheda as kutastha or jiva in the jiva triad, three sattas of jiva, one of them is paramarthika, who is kutastha, called as kutastha. So what is the objection? Kutastha isn't there. How do you consider kutastha? Other three are fine. Jiva, Isha and Brahma are fine. Kutastha is not included elsewhere. It is there in Dhrividrishya Viveka also, and elsewhere also it is mentioned. So who is kutastha? We know kutastha is Brahma Abhinna Paramarthika Satta of Jiva. Jiva Brahmo, Jiva Brahmaiva Na Aparaha. Tasya Shravana Matrana. What is a Shrunu? Uchyamanam Chaitanya Lakshanam, which is Chaturvidha. Understand this. Listen and understand. Tasya Shravana Matrana. Understand this example. Okay. Example and the exemplified. If you understand this well, Tasya Shravana Matrana Vicharasya Mahaphalam Brahmajnanam Avapyeta. One would attain this. One would attain Brahmajnana. So this methodology, just examples are not examples. If you understand the example, how it is used in the case of the exemplified, the doubtless knowledge will lead to Brahmajnana. Otherwise, people think, what is this Mahakasha and Ghatakasha, all this? It is to drive home the point of Aikya. If you land on Aikya, that itself is Brahmajnana. Aikya Jnana is Brahmajnana. It is Moksha Karaka. Therefore, Vicharasya Mahaphalam Avapyeta. What is that Mahaphala? Brahma Jnana. Kutastha Varnanam. So, who is the Kutastha now? We take the four Chaitanya Bhedas. Buddhehe Vyashtya Jnanasya Va Adishthana Bhuta Chaitanyasya Va Kutastha Iti Abhidha. Kutastha is a name given to whom? We saw Paramarthika Jiva. Who is that? Buddhehe Vyashti Ajnanasya. Individual Ajnana is called as Ajnana. At a total level, it is called as Maya. So at an individual level, Maya is called as Ajnana. That Ajnana, Buddhehe Vyashti Ajnanasya Va. Sorry, yeah, Buddhehe Vyashti Ajnanasya Va Adhishtana Bhuta Chaitanyasya Kutastha Vida. I read va again here. That's va isn't here. Buddhehe va vyashti ajnanasya va. That is how it is. Buddhehe adishthana bhuta chaitanyasya va vyashti ajnanasya va. What adishthana? Basically what? It is adishthana bhuta chaitanya. Adishthana to what? Either to buddhi or to vyashti ajnana. Both ways it can be seen. Because there are various methodologies and various Advaita Granthas talk about Kutastha differently. Jiva is explained differently based on the Prakriya. Prakriya Bheda is there. Any Prakriya is fine because all Prakriyas have their goal as Advaita Siddhanta Aikya. Jiva Brahma Aikya. So Buddhehe Adishthana Bhuta Chaitanyasya, which is not different from what? Vyashti Ajnana Adishthana Bhuta Chaitanya. So Buddhehe va Vyashti Ajnanasya va Adishthana Bhuta Chaitanyasya Kutastha iti Abhidha. Whether it is the Adishthana for Buddhi or for Vyashti Ajnana, individual Ajnana, that is called as, that Chaitanya is called as Kutastha. Now there is a Tippana there. Jeevaha Buddhi Pratibimbaha iti Avidya Pratibimbaha iti cha Vakshamanatvad Atra Pakshadvayam Suchitam. Jiva is either Buddhi Pratibimba, meaning Antakrana Pratibimba, or called as Avidya Pratibimba. There are both ways in which it is seen. Avidya Pratibimba is Jiva, Maya Pratibimba is Ishvara. That is one way it is explained. Or Maya Pratibimba is Ishvara, and Maya is the Antakrana of Ishvara. In that case, we say Buddhi Pratibimba is Jiva, where Buddhi is Antakkarana. Antakkarana Pratibimba or Buddhi Pratibimba is Jiva. So either way it is said, Now, if Jiva is either Buddhi Pratibimba or Avidya Pratibimba, then the Adhishthana for Buddhi and Avidya is that Chaitanya, which is called as Kutastha. Yanmate Buddhi Vishishtas Chetanaha Jivaha Tanmate Buddhi Adhishthana Chetanaha Kutastha Ityuchyate. Yatra tu mate Vyakti Ajnana Vishishtas Chetanaha Jivaha Iti Kirtyate Tanmate Vyakti Ajnana Adhishthana Chetana Kutastha Iti Varnyate. So you take either case. In one case, Buddhi Vishishta Chetana is called as Jiva. There, that Adhishthana, its Adhishthana is Kutastha. Whereas in another Mata, in another paksha, Vyashti Ajnana Vishishta is Chetana, who is Jiva. That Chetana which has Vaishishtya of Vyashti Ajnana or Buddhi. Either way, you have defined Jiva, the Adhishthana Chetana is called as Kutastha. Atrayam Siddhanta. What is the Siddhanta there? Jivatva Padakam Visheshanam Yatva. Tad adhisthanasya kutastha iti naam. So, you have any prakriya. However you define jiva, whatever is the visheshana to Brahma Chaitanya, which will make that Brahma individualized, so to say, as though individualized, and make jiva, meaning Brahma, whichever visheshana to Brahma lands on jivatvam of Brahma, that yat visheshanam jivatva padakam brahmana, we can say Brahma Chaitanyasya jivatva padakam yad visheshanam tadadishthanasya. So if Buddhi is the visheshana to Brahma Chaitanya, upadhi, actually it is an upadhi, but when you take it as a visheshana, he becomes a samsari. There is a segmentation. That segmentation, whatever is the attribute that is going to segment the Brahma, Pratibimba. In Pratibimba, through Pratibimba. With Avachedavada, with an upadhi of like a Ghata upadhi, similarly some upadhi. However you segment, whatever is the Visheshana used to create divisions, the Adhishthana of that Visheshana is called as Kutastha. Adhishthana happens to be Chaitanya. So, Jivatva Padakam Visheshana Yat Tad Adhishthanasya Kutastha Iti Nama Ayam Kutastha Utpatyadi Rahitaha. That Kutastha does not have any Janma Ityadi. He is free. The Kutastha Chaitanya is same as Brahma. There is no division at all. Real division isn't there. Division is created by Visheshana, adding Visheshana. This is an upadhi. In the real sense, it is an upadhi. But for vyavahara, we use that visheshana. But the kutastha does not have any utpatti. The visheshana has an utpatti. Buddhi has a utpatti. Utpatti. Buddhi has an utpatti. How? Across kalpas, there is reshaping of the buddhi the way it was. It is remanifested. That's all. Sharira, the sthula sharira, has a real utpatti, vyavaharika utpatti, across janmas, not across kalpas, across janmas. However, the sukshma sharira, antakrana buddhi, and avidya also continues across kalpas. But that continuation across kalpas is also figuratively called as utpatti. Although anadi, but it is remanifest. Asya ayam avipraya. What is the idea? This is Siddhanta, but what is the idea? Brahmana vyatirikta taya chidabhasa yatha utpadyate na tata kutastha utpadyeta or utpadyate. The way chidabhasa is born, because chidabhasa is an abhasa or a pratibimba. Abhasa comes up and goes. Pratibimba comes and goes with the medium of reflection. However, the reflecting consciousness, which is the original Bimba, this kutastha which is in the pratibimba vada which is bimba does not have utpatti laya ityadi kintu brahma roopa eva sa bhavati brahma does not have brahma is ajata brahma not only anadi ananta other anadis may come and go they may not have an utpatti but they have an end avidya has an end brahma does not have an end brahma roopa eva sa bhavati kutastha therefore utpatyadi rahitah yatha ghatakasho mahakasha na vyatiriktah see you see abhasa pratibimba the ghatakasha all are used in vichara sagara all are used appropriately because all have one value which is not there in the other we have to use the strengths of each prakriya to land on the tattva instead of arguing what is the bheda you know what is the difference between the two this not much of use of you know trying to split hairs between vadas and finding doshas that is for purvapakshis for phds it's okay but to land on the tattva you should see how all of these get to the goal of aikya if we understand that is the strength of each vada we should focus on the strengths of the vada finding flaws in the vadas or we become a purvapakshi thinking like a purvapakshi all the time is not helpful what else can I find what other flaws can I find that is useless pursuit the pursuit should be do I have doubts does another have doubts which I can answer not to find flaws in the prakriya there are people who want to stick to something or who are not advaitins they keep on finding flaws in each vada and put you against the other so you keep on fighting they think that they have won by making one prakriya of the advaita one prakriya creator of the in the advaita grantha opposed to another you know make them fight and then they say okay see you have issues at your end that is why our so called prakriya or our vedanta or whatever philosophy darshana is right that's not how it works so we should focus on the positives of each vada and land on aikya so asya ayam abhipraya brahmano vyatiriktataya chidabhaso yatha utpadyate na tata kutastha utpadyate kintu brahma rupeva sabhoti yatha ghatakasho mahakasha na vyatiriktah the ghatakasha is not separate from mahakasha in the example that is being used here ghatakasha is not different from mahakasha and ghatakasha happens to be what ghatakasha is kutastha mahakasha is brahma so between kutastha and brahma there is no difference kintu mahakasha roopa eva bhavati sah ghatakasha similarly brahma and kutastha have no difference kutastha is brahma roopa eva tadvat अयञ्च कूटस्थ आत्मपद लक्ष्यार्थः वाच्यार्थ ऑफ दि त्वंपद वाच्यार्थ इज जीव हाउएवर आत्मपद लक्ष्यार्थः और त्वंपद लक्ष्यार्थ इज कूटस्थः कूटस्थ चैतन्य कूटस्थस्यैव प्रत्यगात्मा इति निजस्वरूपम् इति jiva sakshi iti cha vyapadeshah the same kutastha is called as pratyagatma nija swarupam what is the swarupatah who is jiva he is kutastha he is chaitanya these are the names given jiva sakshi 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 chaitanya sakshi all these words are other words for kutastha kutastha ghatakasha sthaniyah in the example he has a sthan of kutastha has a sthan of ghatakashah जीव स्वरूप वर्णनम सो सेकंड इज जीव कूटस्थ जीव ईशा एंड ब्रह्म सो हु इज जीव व्हाट इज द जीव स्वरूप लक्षण बुद्धि प्रतिबिंब चैतन्यम जीवः जीव इज प्रतिबिंब चैतन्य रिफ्लेक्टेड इन द बुद्धि बट देयर इज मोर इट इज नॉट इट इज इट्स अ कैजुअल वे ऑफ पुटिंग इट बट अदर्स आर इंक्लूडेड व्हेन यू से प्रतिबिंब देन द chaitanya is there pratibimba has to be there pratibimba where the pratibimba takes place so chaitanya is bimba pratibimba is there and buddhi buddhi where the pratibimba takes place. That also has to be there. Buddhi is an effect of sattva guna. Pradhanyam. Pradhanyata sattva guna is there. So sattva guna reflects chaitanya, can reflect chaitanya. Therefore, buddhi is the closest. That is why chaitanya can be known only in buddhi. That is why only jnana can lead to moksha. Buddhi has the pratibimba of chaitanya. Therefore, buddhi, pratibimba and chaitanya, all three inclusive are jiva. Although we say chaitanya is jiva, but when you use jiva as a samsari jiva, that time chaitanya cannot be a samsari. Pratibimba cannot be a samsari. Buddhi has to be there. Buddhi, pratibimba and chaitanya, all three are there. Then there is a possibility, because pratibimba is jada. Buddhi is also jada. Chaitanya brings them to act. So what is the jiva swarupa really? Ananta koti kama karma vasana vasita buddhau pratiphalita chaitanya pratibimbaha jivaha iti vidvadbhir uchyate. So who is jiva? The vidwans say, those who know, they say jiva is ananta koti kama karma vasana vasita buddhi. In that buddhi, buddhau, in a buddhi which has vasanas, which are ananta koti kama karma vasana. Avidya continuing, there is kama and karma. These will leave behind vasana. Kama vasana will also be there, karma vasana will also be there. And then one will continue to have raga dvesha adi rupa kama and then karma for the phalecha. Whether it is avoiding through dvesha or trying to have pravritti and get something by yoga through raga. They are ananta koti. Because anadi. Anadi kalena there is pravritti. Therefore, ananta koti kama karma vasana vasita buddham. In the antakkarana, where the antakkarana plays the role of buddhi, the manifested vasanas are there. Then one acts out. But in such a buddhi, in that kind of antakkarana or buddhi, pratiphalita chaitanya, pratibimbaha jivaha iti vidvadbhir uchyate. The chaitanya pratibimba is pratiphalita. Pratiphalita, the phalana is there. What happens is that when the reflection is there, that reflection as though comes to life. That is called as pratiphalanam. And that pratiphalita chaitanya pratibimba, that chaitanya which brings alive the pratibimba, that pratibimba coming alive by the chaitanya bringing it to life, that is called as jiva iti vidvadbhir uchyate. Nahi tat pratibimba matram jiva ityuchyate. The pratibimba alone is not jiva. Kintu yatha ghatakasha sahita akasha pratibimba jalakasha iti kachyate. Evam kutastha sahita chidabhaso jiva iti kirtyate. Just like ghatakasha, along with ghatakasha, there is akasha pratibimba. That is jalakasha. Jalakasha is not just the akasha pratibimba. Along with ghatakasha, it is called a jalakasha. In the example, similarly, kutastha sahita chidabhasa. Chidabhasa is not jiva, but along with the kutastha chaitanya is jiva. This chidabhasa cannot be there unless buddhi is there. So buddhi is included when you say chidabhasa. Therefore, not just chidabhasa, not just the reflection, but the reflection, reflecting medium has to be there. Otherwise, you won't have chidabhasa. Abhasa also cannot be there. You need not say reflection, but even for abhasa to take place, there has to be something. If there is an abhasa of chaura, the abhasa cannot take place unless something is there. There has to be a stump of a tree, something has to be there in that, you know, the twilight zone darkness. And when you see through the corner of your eye, even in daylight it's possible, you see the corner of your eye, you make sudden movements, but then there is an abhasa that the something moved on your right side, let's say. happens to be a tree or a lamp or a, you know, lamp post or something, but through the corner of the eye, something moved, you have moved, or something else moved, but then we think that the lamp post or the tree moving, we miss it to be tree or a lamp post, we think it is a chaura. Somebody is following me. That abhasa also cannot take place unless there is a lamp post or a stump of a tree. Something has to be there. Thereby, chidabhasa is not possible unless kutastha chaitanya chit is there, and that chit should reflect somewhere or create an abhasa. To create an abhasa also, something else should be there which is moving. So to say, moving the chit as though. That has to be there. That is called a jiva, a triad actually. Tasmad buddhistha chidabhasaha. Although it is said, chidabhasa is not possible unless buddhi is there. So buddhistha chidabhasaha, buddhyadhisthana chaitanyam cha iti ubhayam militva jiva iti siddhyati. Here it has been said, kutastha sahita chidabhasa. Here it is said, buddhistha chidabhasa. So kutastha is there, which is chaitanya. Chidabhasa is there. That chidabhasa is buddhista, present in the buddhi. Therefore, all three are there. Buddhi adhishthana chaitanyam cha. So, buddhista chidabhasa means chidabhasa in buddhi. So, buddhi has to be there. And chidabhasa is there. So, two are there. Then, buddhi adhishthana chaitanyam cha. Iti ubhayam. Although two are considered, buddhista chidabhasa says buddhi is there. Otherwise, chidabhasa won't be there. And buddhyadhisthana chaitanyam. So chidabhasa plus buddhyadhisthana chaitanyam. Buddhistha chidabhasa and buddhyadhisthana chaitanya. So buddhi is common between the two. For buddhi, adhisthana is chaitanya. And the same adhisthana chaitanya has association with buddhi in such a manner that there is chidabhasa born. Utpatti. It has chidabhasa as an utpatti. Iti ubhayam militva jiva iti siddhyati. That is the jiva. Now, I'll go through this. This is a complicated section. Not complicated per se, but then all combinations or possibilities other than what has been explained as jiva is refuted. Combinations or individuals. Individual components or their combinations as possible are refuted to be jiva. The only possibility is what has been explained in the Mula. We'll look at this in the next part, three. I'll just go ahead and see what is next. Okay, see the point is quite large, you know. The Tippana goes across the page. So we'll look at the third Tippana, which continues from the earlier page. Next. In the next part, right now we can close by saying tasmad buddhistha chidabhasa buddhyadhisthana chaitanyam cha iti ubhayam militva jiva iti siddhyati. So that is the jiva. We look at abhasa swarupa vivechanam. Before looking at this, we look at the tippana next. So I'll leave the page hanging here. So we'll continue with the tippana in the next part, which would be on Friday. No Patha tomorrow. Sukhan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurupi Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Ketu Nirmanam Aparam Sarvedanta Vidyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadevaham Namatto Netiti Menishchitamatihi. Any questions? Namaste.